The sacrifice of Imam al-Hussein has been mourned for thousands of years before 62 AH, when the armies of Umar al-Sa'd and Ibn Ziyad, under the orders of Yazid, killed the Imam along with his family and companions. The Prophet himself, along with Imam Ali and Imam al-Hassan, are reported on numerous occasions by historians of all denominations to have foretold this divine event. A sacrifice that not only saved Islam, but inspired countless generations with the principles of love, honor, and sacrifice. This series aims to decode how this event unfolded, looking at the most prominent characters and events in the lead up to the 10th of Muharram.
Imam Hussein was being asked by Yazid to give allegiance, which was clearly refused by Imam Hussein alayhi salam, and Imam Hussein did not find any way to save Islam from diminishing total collapse, but to fight against Yazid, knowing for sure that he will be killed. كأني بأوصالي تقطعها. Very clear, he said, I know, my grandfather told me. He was sure that he will be killed, but no way was available to save Muslims from total disaster and Islam from total failure, but to sacrifice his life, his children, his pious companions in that tragic way, that shock will make the dying body of the Muslim Ummah wake up. Like the electric shock, which makes some hearts which are about to die come back to movement. That exactly what happened. Imam Hussein alayhi salam gave the Muslim Ummah the shock of life and made the whole Ummah think, what happened? The grandson of the Prophet, the greatest and the best human being of his time, was killed by a person who claims to be the head of the Muslim state. That was the start of the life of Islam, which is existing till today and till the day of judgment.
While this series has aimed to investigate how the tragedy of Ashura took place, we can't forget that the Prophet himself foretold what was to happen. How does this change the way we perceive the events that lead up to the 10th of Muharram?
Allah's knowledge is absolute. And Allah informed the Prophet. In fact, Allah informed the previous prophets also. We have got authentic hadiths in Sunni books as well that the previous prophets also mentioned that the grandson of the last and greatest prophet will be martyred in a place called Karbala. The prophet himself, on the day of the birth of Imam Hussein, he was being informed by Jibreel that this is your grandson who will be martyred in Karbala by people who will claim that they are Muslims. And Imam Hussein mentioned that, and he wept, and he made people with him weep and cry. The Prophet repeated in many occasions. One of our ulama, Allama Sheikh الأميني, the author of Al-Ghadir, the famous book. He has a book in which he collected many hadiths from Sunni sources only that the Prophet mentioned the martyrdom of Imam Hussein in many occasions, and he wept and he made people with him weep and cry on this disaster which will take place. No doubt Imam Hussein was sure that he will be killed in Karbala, and that is the only way to save Islam. Allah knows that Islam will be misused by some rulers, and Muawiyah and his son Yazid went to the extreme of misusing Islam and to the extreme of diminishing the Islamic values, and their plan was to to finish off any Islamic practice or faith and to go back to the Jahiliyyah before Islam. And their dream was to have an empire like the Persian Empire and the Roman Empire without any religion. The only way to save this message, which is the last and final message for guiding the human beings till the day of judgment, was the sacrifice of the grandson of the Prophet, Imam Hussein, and no way else to save Islam.
With the sacrifice of Imam al-Hussein foretold centuries before, many then wonder why Allah allowed such a thing to happen. What is the philosophy behind such an event when the outcome was already foretold?
Yes, it was known. Known. But no one can say that Allah wanted that. No. Allah does not want any wrong. Allah knows that this crime will take place. Knowledge does not mean that Allah has ordered the criminal to commit the crime. Allah knows that Qabil will kill Habil. Allah's knowledge does not mean that Allah has ordered the killer to kill the victim. Allah knows that the Prophet Yahya will be killed by a tyrant ruler, but that does not mean that Allah has ordered the tyrant ruler to kill the Prophet Yahya. Allah knows that, and Allah made the greatest achievement of saving the greatest religion, which is the religion for all the generations to come till the day of judgment. Allah made that achievement in the hands of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, the grandson of the greatest prophet and the fifth of Ashabul Kisa. We cannot understand Karbala from beginning till end without knowing the fact that Imam Hussein alayhi salam was going willingly to sacrifice his life for the sake of Allah. No one can say that Imam Hussein was killed because he fought to get the chair, and usually when you fight, either you succeed or you are defeated. No, Imam Hussein did not want a chair. Otherwise, how come 72 only face tens of thousands? We have got narrations, minimum number 30,000. The army from 30 going to much more than that, up to 100,000, more, less. In fact, they say that the army was from Karbala up to Sham, different groups of people coming to fight against Imam Hussein. And Imam Hussein was all together 72. It goes against the logic how to fight. And he was being offered many times to put his hand in the hands of Yazid's man and he will be safe. He said, never, never. Allah, إن الدعي بن الدعي قد ركز بين اثنتين بين السلة والذلة وهيهات من الذلة. Means Ubaydullah bin Ziyad, the illegitimate child of the illegitimate father, is giving me two options. Either by giving allegiance to Yazid or killing. And giving allegiance to Yazid is impossible. So he insisted on martyrdom, knowing that his martyrdom is the only way. Imam Hussein did not find any way to save Islam but martyrdom. If Imam Hussein had peace treaty with Yazid, that will mean that Yazid will continue destroying Islam. And the lesson of the peace treaty with Muawiyah is already in hand. So no question of peace treaty with Yazid at all. Nothing remained but only to fight against Yazid. Not for any hope that Imam Hussein might be the ruler. No, Imam Hussein does not care for government or rule, no. But only to save Islam by the only way, which is martyrdom. And that exactly what happened. The history of Muslims from Karbala till today has thousands of evidences that the martyrdom of Imam Hussein in Karbala was the instigator, which made millions and millions of Muslims stand against wrong, against tyranny. And that martyrdom made the lovers of real Islam keep steadfast on the Islamic teachings. And that martyrdom of Imam Hussein gave the human beings in general the best lessons of the sacrifice for the noble cause. In the history of those who became Muslims in many countries, in Asia, in Africa, and other continents, hundreds of millions of people entered Islam because of the love or appreciation or admiring the great values of Imam Hussein, who sacrificed to save these great values, which are the values of Islam, which made all these hundreds of millions of people enter under this blessed and enlightened religion. So Imam Hussein's martyrdom was the start of the new and continuous life of Islam. And we understand the hadith of the Prophet, which is in Sunni and Shia books, when the Prophet said, Husaynun minni wa ana min Husayn. Husayn is from me. Of course, Husayn is grandson. He is from him. But look, when he says, the Prophet says, peace be upon him and his whole progeny, ana min Husayn, I am from Husayn. How come the grandfather becomes from his grandson. The meaning of it, that the continuation of the teachings of the Prophet, means Islamic real teachings, will continue because of the martyrdom of Imam Hussein alayhi salam.
Did Allah not intervene because He wanted the people to have the example of Imam al-Hussein? Can we look at the tragedy in that way?
No doubt that Allah has given the human beings the best example. Allah has granted the human beings best pious leaders, the best divine leaders, who are Muhammad and his holy progeny, peace be upon him and them. Of course, that is a blessing from Allah. But the crime which was committed in Karbala was because of the criminals. No one can justify the crime that Allah wanted that. You see, when they try to justify the crime of the killing of Imam Hussein, they say, Allah wanted that, and if Allah didn't want it, it should not happen. You ask them, did Allah want the Prophet Yahya to be killed? Did Allah want Habil to be killed by Qabil? Okay, go to your own history. Did Allah want the Caliph Umar ibn al-Khattab to be killed by his killer? Did Allah want Uthman to be killed by those who killed him? You cannot justify anything claiming that Allah wanted that. No. Allah never wants any wrong. The wrongdoer does wrong because of his own insisting to do wrong. And he is responsible. And no one can justify the wrong claiming that Allah wanted that.
The entire event took place in half a day, a mere few hours. However, a look through history highlights just what kind of repercussions the killing of Imam al-Hussein had on humanity.
The tragedy of Karbala started the new birth of Islam. Islam, which was being undermined and diminishing, in fact, under the acts and plannings of the tyrant rulers of Bani Umayyah, Muawiyah, then Yazid. After Karbala, the trend started going up towards the teachings of Islam. Quran, the Prophet, Ahlul Bayt, every Muslim almost came to know that this government is un-Islamic. Otherwise, how come they kill the most pious human being on that time, who is Imam Hussein, who is the grandson of the Prophet? So the history started going in the trend of going back, means reviving the Islamic teachings. The fall of the Umayyad dynasty was one of the results of Karbala. Abbasis misused the slogan of the tragedy of Karbala, and their slogan was Ya Lisarat al-Hussein. This slogan, which was raised by many, that they want the revenge from the killers of Imam Hussein, and they captured the government. Of course, after that, they did not fulfill their duty, but they turned enemies to Ahlul Bayt, most of them, most of the Abbasid rulers. Karbala also initiated hundreds of movements against tyranny. In the Muslim history, you'll find hundreds of movements in different countries. In the whole Muslim world, movements of people who were against the wrong, led by the name of Imam Hussein. So the name of Imam Hussein alayhi salam and the sacrifice of Imam Hussein alayhi salam in Karbala caused some type of immunity among the Muslim Ummah against the wrongdoers. And it was the factor of lot of movements against the wrongdoers. Even to today, till today, or before 100 years or 200 years, I give you a few examples. In Iraq, when the Britishers invaded Iraq after the fall of the Osmani government, of course, the Shia ulama who were suffering from the Osmani rulers. The Osmani rulers were clearly discriminating against the Shias in Iraq and other places. They have killed tens of thousands of Shias in Syria, in Turkey, and even in Iraq. But when the Britishers attacked the Osmani government, the ulama in Najaf said that Muslims should support Muslims. In spite of that, the Osmani government could not continue. Who led the revolutions against the invaders? The Shia ulama. Thawratul Ashreen is one example. The revolution of the year 1920 in Iraq. Go before that to the biggest revolution in India against the invaders. It was being instigated in the city of Lucknow in India, led by Shia ulama and Shia believers. One of the examples is Tipu Sultan. His name is in fact Haider Ali, who had an Imam Bara, Husayniya. And from that, he led big revolution against the invaders. You have hundreds of examples that the history of Muslims and the history of the world has been changed after Karbala. Karbala has given the human beings enrichment, support, high values of sacrifice for the noble cause. And now, the non-Muslims need to know more about the values of Imam Hussein. They should not think that the values of Imam Hussein are only for Muslims. Wrong. It is not only for Muslims. It is for everyone. Imam Hussein had his own army, even non-Muslims, Christians. You know, Wahab, John. So, Imam Hussein's mission is to save the human beings from wrongdoers and from evil acts, from injustice, from discrimination, from every bad act. Non-Muslims today need to know more about Imam Hussein. That will help them a lot in changing their situation, in getting rid of the wrongdoers. It depends up to what extent the followers of Imam Hussein, the followers of Imam Hussein can convey the message of Imam Hussein to others. Let me take the last few years. Do you know what is called the Arab Spring? what was the main factor behind it? The main factor behind the spring of the Arab spring in Tunisia, in Egypt, in Bahrain, in Yemen, and other places, the main is the values of Imam Hussein in standing against the wrongdoers. Otherwise, why the Arab people in these countries did not stand against the wrongdoers before more than 1,000 years till today? Why? Because that time, the ideas of Imam Hussein or the values of Imam Hussein were not reaching everyone. Now, in the recent years, when the message went through the satellite TVs and the communications, people came to know about Imam Hussein, who did whatever he did for saving Islam and for stopping the wrongdoers. And you find the effect on the millions of Arab Muslims who changed their attitude. You know, in the main Sunni books like Muslim, Bukhari, and others, you find clear teachings not to go against the ruler, even if the ruler is doing wrong. Don't object on him. Don't object on him. That is in the books, because these books were being written under the influence of the rulers themselves, the wrongdoers. But the Muslim, millions of Muslim Arabs, left aside what is in Bukhari and Muslim and their own books of hadith, and followed the attitude of Imam Hussein to stand against the wrong rulers, and they did what they could do. This is also another effect of Karbala, and the effect will go on. It will go on. In every country, as far as the love of Imam Hussein is there, you will find the sacrifice. You will find the high values. You will find the cooperation. You will find people loving each other. You will find every good. As far as the values of Imam Hussein alayhi salam is there, and go and see yourself. Go see the millions of people who go every year walking to visit the shrine of Imam Hussein in Karbala, and try to study their behavior with each other, and see, you will never find on the whole earth such huge gathering peacefully. Everyone is cooperating with the other as if all of them are brothers and sisters. You cannot find that, because this is one fruit of the love of Imam Hussein, who was aiming and could successfully achieve his aim in making people come back to the real teachings of Islam.